Welcome dear student, in the last lecture we have seen what is velocity and what is acceleration. Now let us move ahead. In this lesson we see graphical representation of motion. Graphical representation of motion. Now we know what the graph is. In your previous standard 8 you have learned about bar graph, line graph, histogram, pie chart, etc. In this lesson we use line graphs, like this kind of line graphs. In line graph we have two axes, y axis and x axis. Remember, y axis is dependent axis. We describe quantity over y axis, which is dependent on quantity on x axis. Which means, if we take example of this graph, here on y axis we took distance, that is in kilometer, and on x axis we took time in hour, which means this distance covered is dependent on time, and we write this graph as y versus x graph, which means distance versus time graph. So we call this graph as distance time graph. Okay, so for uniform speed, a graph of distance travel against time is a straight line. Now we know what is uniform speed. Uniform speed means in equal time interval distance covered by the object will be equal. Let us see in this example. 0 to 1 means in first hour object covers distance of 50 km. As you can see, in 1 hour object cover distance of 50 km. In second hour object reaches to see 100 km, which means in second hour, means first to second hour, in this 1 hour object covers this much of 50 km distance. In third hour object cover another 50 km, means in each hour object cover 50 km, that is the same distance covered by object, which means object cover uniform distance, which means speed of this object is uniform. As you can see that graph of uniform speed is linear graph. Now let us see what we can derive from this graph. We can derive average speed or speed of object by this graph. How? Let us take two points, say point A and B. We take point A here and point B here. These two points are our observation point. Means we are observing these two point. A point starting time is 2 hour. On B point our ending time is 3 hour, which means let us say this time is t1 and this time is t2, which means t1 is 2 hour and t2 is 3 hour. At second hour distance covered by object is 100 km, and on third hour distance covered by object is 2 km. Let's mark it as S1 and S2. Now if we want speed, we know that we need two different things. What two different things? One is a distance cover and one is a time taken. So here we have a distance cover is S2 minus S1. We can see that S2 is 150 km minus S1 is 100 km. Divide time taken. To cover this 150 minus 100, that is 50 km, object took 3 minus 2. Here T2 is 3, T1 is 2, which means 1 hour. So here we get 50 divide 1. That is 50 km/h. So from this graph we can say that object travel with the speed of 50 km per hour. And we can easily convert this km per hour into our required unit, as we seen in previous lecture, in meter per second, mm per second, meter per minute, etc. We have discussed what is graph for uniform speed. Now let us discuss what is graph for non-uniform speed. Yes, here graph is for non-uniform speed, but we will not say as non-uniform speed, but rather we will say that distance time graph for accelerated motion. Notice accelerated motion. Now we know that what is accelerated motion and what is acceleration. Remember the acceleration? Acceleration is change in velocity with respect to time, which means to get acceleration or accelerated motion, velocity must change. So we took some data here. In this case, distance is not constant in every time interval. Here notice that time interval is 2 seconds, which means 0 to 2, 2 second time interval, 2 to 4, 2 second time interval, 4 to 6, 2 second time interval. In every 2 second time interval, object covers different distance. On 0 second, object is at 0 meter. After 2 second, object is at 1 meter. After more 2 second, it means 4 second, object is at 4 meter. After more 2 second, which means at 6th second, object is at 9 meter, and so on. On first 2 second, object travels 1 minus 0, that is 1 meter. On second 2 second, object travels 4 minus 1, that is 3 meter. On third 2 second, object travels 9 minus 4, that is 5 meter, which means same time interval but distance cover is not same. Let us put this data on the graph. As usual, the graph is distance versus time graph. We took distance on y-axis and time on x-axis. Let us put this data in graph. You can see this at 0, position is 0, at 2, position is at 1, at 4 meter, 4 second, position is at 4 second, and so on. And connect all this point, we get one graph that is non-linear, which means graph for accelerated motion is non-linear, and for graph for uniform speed is linear. Now dear students, let's take few examples. First of all, read the question of example number 8.3. You can see that Usha swims in a swimming pool. She starts from the point, let's say O, and she goes to other end of swimming pool and come back on the same path to starting point. Swimming pool is 90 meter long, which means she cover total distance of 90 plus 90, that is 180. To travel this 180 in swimming pool, she takes 1 minute, which means total distance traveled by Usha is 180 meter. We have to find average speed and average velocity. Now we remember the formula of average speed, that is total distance divide total time. In this case, our total distance is 90 plus 90, that is 180 meter, and time taken is 1 minute. To derive the answer in meter per second, we have to convert this minute into second. We know that 1 minute is 60 seconds, and by simple calculation, we can derive the answer 3 meter per second, that is our average speed. Now, what is the difference between speed and velocity? As we know that speed is scalar quantity and velocity is vector quantity. If we take right hand side distance covered as positive, we have to take left hand side distance as negative, which means USA covers plus 90 distance and minus 90 distance, which means plus 90 minus 90 is equal to 0, which means displacement of USA is 0 meter, which means starting point and end point is same. So average velocity is, remember these two formula and difference between this formula. Average velocity is equal to displacement divide total time. Here displacement is 0 and time taken is 1 minute. 0 divide anything gives 0, which means we get average speed as 0 meter per second. Let's take another example. First of all, read question from the textbook. Data is given that Rahul is started from the resting position and acquired 6 meter per second velocity after 30 seconds. After that, he applied brakes and his velocity decreases to 4 meter per second in 5 seconds. So we have to find acceleration in both of this case. Let us say first case. In first case, he started his journey from the rest, which means starting velocity or initial velocity is 0 meter per second. He acquired speed of 6 meter per second after 30 seconds, which means final velocity is 6 meter per second and time is 30 seconds. We know the formula of acceleration, that is final velocity minus initial velocity divide time taken. Here we have a final velocity 6 minus initial velocity 0 and time taken is 30 seconds. And by simple calculation, we get the answer 0.2 meter per second square. Don't forget to write unit after each and every answer. In second case, initial velocity is 6 meter per second and final velocity is 4 meter per second, which means decrease in velocity. We know the formula of acceleration, that is V minus U divide T. Final velocity is 4 meter per second minus initial velocity is 6 meter per second divide time taken is 5 second. 4 minus 6, that is minus 2, divide 5. Multiply 2 with denominator and numerator, we got 0.4, that is negative 0.4 meter per second. Remember, here velocity is decreasing, means acceleration is negative, and we have one word, that is deceleration. What? Deceleration for negative acceleration. Positive acceleration means velocity of the object is increasing, and negative acceleration means velocity of object is decreasing.